Hello, dissenters. My name is Italics, and I am here today returning to beautiful city skylines with a few more workshop additions to show you. Today, we are going to be focusing on functionality primarily, with something that's going to help you take out the trash and something that's going to help you remove trashy parts of your city with ease, as well as my favorite map so far out of the custom creations. This map, we should start with, I think, since we're going to be taking a look at it the most, since I've already got a city of almost 75,000 population built up here, is Vista Falls. And the reason that's my favorite map to date is because of the variety of terrain and the masterful way that that terrain has been made buildable. So just to show you the whole plot that we have to work with here, I've unlocked all of the squares. This is where I have built so far, and you can see I've got about a quarter of the map so far taken advantage of, so there's still a lot of space left to experiment with. And as we zoom in, you can see there are a lot of mountains all the way to the height map. This is as tall as they can go. We got waterfalls underneath our little highways that I've built up the side of the mountain. I've created a little bit more of an organic city compared to the norm. So those of you who like grid-based cities, probably not going to enjoy this map very much because there's not a lot of big blocky area for you to work with. That being said, the reason that it's my favorite, the icing on the cake of this map, is that all of the elevated platforms have been flattened out. This reminds me very much of SimCity from 2013 in that I loved the maps there, but not how small they were. The area that they gave you to build on obviously was not good enough. But here, it's like having just all of the SimCity maps, but just completely open, is what it feels like. And the reason I like the SimCity map so much is because let's say you want to build, you know, up on one of these hills areas. So maybe you start down here, and as you work your way up, the author has given you some lovely slopes that you can easily get some highways up. And once you make it to the top, you've got a bunch of flattened area to work with. So it might look a little bit unrealistic. This is not going to suit those of you who love height maps, but the area that is buildable, I love the fact that it's all level so that your city is not going to have any problems with sloping roads not working properly, or let's say maybe you want to build up on a mountain next to another waterfall. This looks like a volcano waterfall. How are you going to do that? Well, like I said, the author's got you covered. Maybe you start building at the base of the mountain. Oh, look, a very easy slope that you can wind a road all the way up and another flattened plateau for you to work on. And if you want to go up even higher, well, that's going to have to get a little bit more creative with some roads going around the edges of the mountain before you can build up on these little planes. So overall, great map. I would give it the highest of ratings. 2 thumbs up. Highly recommend that you try this one out just because of the sheer variety of terrain that we have to work with here. All right, now let's get to the actual gameplay changes. This is the first map I've actually wanted to spotlight, and I feel like it was very well deserved. Let us begin with a little bit of recycling. So I've downloaded a recycling center edition. So this complements the landfill and the incinerator, which come default with the game. Now you'll notice I've got actually 2 recycling plants here. The one that I want to spotlight right now that I feel is a little bit better, a little more balanced, is this. So the recycling center is, of course, all of these are linked in the description of this video if you want to check those out. It looks like we're having a bit of a trash problem over here. Nobody is getting to this plane in this territory. So I want to find out where my noisy structures are. Here's some offices and some shops so they don't mind the noise. And the nice thing about the recycling is it is completely clean. So you can build these and rest assured that your people are not going to have to deal with pollution. That might sound a little bit overpowered to you, which is fine. That's absolutely normal and anticipated, but we're going to place 2 of them here together and try to show you the difference. So first of all, you'll notice the cost. It costs $45,000, which is inherently more by about 50% than the incineration plant, so it's slightly more expensive. Also, the noise pollution has been doubled from 50 to 100, so you have to worry about that as well. It's going to trouble your citizens a little bit more with that extra noise. And finally, it has a smaller capacity, so 250,000 in the reserves is what is possible, compared to the incineration plant, which has a reserve of 400,000. So all in all, more expensive for less space. You get 8 garbage trucks instead of, I don't recall exactly, I want to say it's a lot. Let's just build one just to find out how many trucks you get with the plant. 27! So overall, it seems fairly well balanced. The one thing I would like to see changed is the upkeep cost. The upkeep cost of the incineration plant is $1,400. Recycling is only $960. I feel like this should be at least identical to the incineration plant, minimum, but that's just my opinion. So, A couple of these are going to make up for one incineration plant, so definitely more expensive overall, but a nice, clean alternative to getting rid of trash and waste throughout your city. Speaking of getting rid of trash and waste, this is my favorite addition yet. Also, what is going on here? The train is waiting for... The train can't go... Oh, it can! It can't go through the soundproof walls. Wow. Who knew that you could make train tracks on the highway? Not I. I'm gonna have to fix that later. Speaking of fixing it later, though, let's just try demolishing it with the bulldoze marquee tool. So, here on the bottom right, you can see next to the bulldozer, we have a marquee. I can select nodes, buildings, or trees. Let's experiment with these individual settings now. Trees is going to allow me to get rid of a lot of trees in an area by drawing a marquee, which is wonderful, and since you can designate what you want it to delete, I can do this without worrying about deleting anything else except for trees. Now, ironically, it's not deleting these trees. So I'm not sure, this might be part of a build. Yep, that's part of the building. Okay, duly noted, let's try this as an example instead. Didn't delete anything except the trees here in the center. So if I switch that over to buildings, of course, we're going to just be able to get rid of buildings very, very quick and efficiently. Now you'll notice the road is still there, so that's a really nice change. The fact that I can deselect everything and only select nodes. Nodes is going to allow me to delete roads and things that you would normally be able to designate zoning on, aka a node, for example. And I'm sure that stretches over two power lines and train tracks, depending on how you want it to do. So this is an easy way to just get rid of old parts of the city you may no longer desire in one fell swoop. So we can do buildings and nodes simultaneously. And poof, an entire city is gone. Now, it might miss a couple things, but it's so easy to go sweep up after yourself that it's really not a problem. And it's so much easier than just using the bulldozer. I've been waiting on a marquee forever. And notice now that we've ruined the city, so let's fix that real quick. And we are good as new. Look, everything's back just the way I had it before. There's no undo button that I know of. I just reloaded a save. But the bulldoze marquee is a big deal, and it just makes getting rid of huge mistakes so much easier. But be careful with that tool, of course. Finally, just a couple quick little aesthetics that I wanted to show off. The Ferris wheel is particularly nifty. Unfortunately, these are not animated. I don't know if it's even possible to animate these. But we've got some theme park attractions if you want. This is one of two that I've got. Park with Ferris wheel. It has a lot of visitor space. So it has a high entertainment value, llama side of 23. You know, you gotta watch out for those llamas. And it's a little tourist attraction for your people. Secondly, and that you can combine nicely with the Ferris wheel, is a roller coaster. So up here we've got a pretty fancy looking roller coaster ride. These actually employ people. So not only do we have visitors, this one also accepts tourists. It has an entertainment value of 60. So a little bit less. Of course, these are, I don't think these are made by the same people. They might be, but I didn't check. The important part is that these will actually give some people jobs as well as entertainment. So really, they just look really nifty. And if you want to make yourself a little impromptu theme park and dream of the roller coaster tycoon that does not exist yet, the modern day roller coaster tycoon, I should say, get those and you can dream a little bit longer. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed my little city here and the new additions that have been helping us out tremendously. I encourage you to check all the links in the description of this video to add those quickly through the workshop for yourself. And thank you for watching. My name is Italics, and I hope to see you soon.